If Israel's F-35I Adir were to penetrate Iranian airspace in a conflict scenario, its ability to evade detection and neutralize threats would depend on a combination of stealth, electronic warfare, and tactical prowess. As the F-35I crosses into Iran, it would face an array of sophisticated S-300 and Bavar-373 surface-to-air missile systems, backed by shorter-range systems such as the Tor M1, Panzer S1, and Kordat 3. These defenses are designated to create a multi-layered barrier to prevent intrusions by high-end threats like the F-35. Let's delve into how the F-35I Adir might deal with these challenges once it enters Iranian airspace, breaking down each phase of its mission and how it might overcome Iranian defenses. The Phase 1, entry into Iranian airspace, the role of stealth. Upon crossing the border into Iranian airspace, the F-35I's stealth capabilities become its primary defense. The aircraft's design minimizes its radar cross-section, allowing it to evade detection by traditional radar systems. While the S-300 and the Bavar-373 SAM systems are advanced and claim anti-stealth capabilities, they would still face significant challenges in detecting, tracking, and locking onto a low-observable aircraft like the F-35I. The S-300 has a range of 200 kilometers and can engage targets at altitudes up to 30,000 meters. It uses phased array radars and is capable of tracking multiple targets, but its performance against stealth aircraft remains debated. The Bavar-373, a domestically produced Iranian system, claims a range of 300 kilometers and also claims that it can engage low RCS targets, positioning itself as an upgraded alternative to the S-300. The S-300 and Bavar-373 detection limitations. The F-35I stealth reduces its radar cross-section to a fraction of traditional aircraft, making it appear on radar as a much smaller object. The phased array radar of the S-300 and Bavar-373, while advanced, may detect a faint trace. But distinguishing this as a hostile aircraft and maintaining a continuous track would be extremely difficult. Also, Iranian radars operate on high-frequency bands to maximize detection range. However, the F-35I's stealth design is optimized to scatter and absorb radar waves, especially in the bands most commonly used by long-range radars, making detection erratic and unreliable at long ranges. The further the F-35I is from radar systems, the lower the chances of detection. Stealth aircraft are particularly effective when they operate at ranges beyond 150 to 200 kilometers, where the radar's ability to detect, track, and lock on diminishes significantly. In practice, this means that the F-35I enters Iranian airspace. Iranian radar systems might detect intermittent signals or ghost images, but not enough to accurately identify or target the aircraft. Phase 2, neutralizing early detection, electronic warfare. As the F-35I approaches high-priority targets, it would rely heavily on electronic warfare to disrupt and degrade Iran's air defense network. Israel's customized electronic warfare suite, integrated into the F-35I, plays a key role in this phase. The F-35I is equipped with high-power jammers that can disrupt the radar signals of Iranian SAM systems like the S-300 and Bavar-373. By overwhelming the radars with false signals, noise, and confusing data, these systems would struggle to accurately track the F-35I. This buys the Israeli fighter precious time to close in on its target before it is detected. The Adir's advanced electronics allow it to create decoy signals, making Iranian defense believe that there are multiple aircraft or that the F-35I is in a different location. This deception can mislead the operators of Iran's air defense systems, causing them to launch missiles at the wrong targets or at false radar returns. It is likely that Israel would complement its electronic warfare with cyber operations to infiltrate and disrupt Iran's air defense communications. In past operations, Israel has been known to use cyber attacks to neutralize or disable enemy systems as seen with Stuxnet against Iran's nuclear facilities. This would degrade Iran's response time and coordination, giving the F-35I a clear advantage. Phase 3. Navigating Iranian terrain, exploiting terrain masking. Once deeper into Iranian airspace, the F-35I's terrain-following radar and the natural geography of the region come into play. Iran's mountainous terrain presents both a challenge and an opportunity for stealth operations. Israeli pilots renowned for their tactical skills would use terrain masking to their advantage, flying low to the ground and using the natural cover provided by mountains and hills to avoid detection. By flying low to the ground, the F-35I can avoid detection by long-range radar systems, which are often positioned to detect high-altitude threats. The mountains in northern and western Iran, for example, could allow the F-35I to sneak close to Iranian air defense systems before they have time to react. Mountains and ridges can create radar shadows where detection is impossible. The F-35I could exploit these blind spots, moving between radar stations without being picked up by overlapping radar coverage. Using this method, the F-35I could approach strategic targets, such as nuclear facilities, missile bases, or command centers without being tracked by Iranian air defenses, engaging high-priority targets' precision strikes. Once in position, the F-35I would switch from a defensive role to an offensive one, using its precision-guided munitions to engage high-priority targets. These targets could include Iran's radar systems, SAM launchers, missile depots, and command and control centers. The F-35I is equipped with long-range, precision-guided munitions like GBU-39 small-diameter bombs or Spies 1000 bombs. These weapons allow the F-35 to strike targets from beyond the range of Iranian air defenses, minimizing the risk of engagement by surface-to-air missiles. In a suppression of enemy air defense mission, the F-35I could deploy anti-radiation missiles designed to home in or the radar emissions of systems like the S-300 or Bavar-373. These missiles would disable or destroy the radar before the Iranian system could launch its own missile. The aircraft's combination of laser-guided bombs and electro-optical targeting system allows for pinpoint accuracy, enabling the aircraft to strike high-value targets while minimizing collateral damage. This precision would be essential in taking out hardened targets, such as underground missile silos or nuclear facilities. Phase 5. Evasion and Return. Escaping Iranian airspace. After striking its targets, the F-35I's next challenge would be to exit Iranian airspace, avoiding retaliation from any surviving air defense systems. Here, the F-35's speed, stealth, and electronic warfare would again come into play. Even if Iran manages to launch surface-to-air missiles in response, the aircraft's advanced electronic countermeasures would allow it to evade these threats. It can deploy flares and chaff to confuse the missile's tracking system, or use its electronic warfare suite to jam the missile's guidance. It can quickly climb to high altitude and accelerate to evade missiles, using its high-speed capabilities to outmaneuver older, less agile systems like the S-300. If the F-35I can outlast the missile's fuel, it would avoid interception. So to conclude this, I would say that in potential conflict, the F-35I Adir would give Israel a significant tactical advantage over Iran's air defense systems. The combination of stealth, electronic warfare, and precision strike capabilities would allow the F-35I to penetrate Iranian airspace, avoid detection, and neutralize key air defense assets with high precision. However, Iran's layered defenses, including the S-300, Bavar-373, and short-range systems, would present significant challenges, particularly in defensively defended areas. Israel would likely need to coordinate cyber attacks, use decoys or drones, and employ high-level tactics to suppress these defenses and achieve air superiority. While Iran's air defense network is formidable, the F-35I's superior technology and Israel's advanced warfare strategies would likely give it the edge in controlling the skies, especially in the initial phases of a conflict. With this, The Buzz is signing off for today. But don't forget to hit that notification bell as we bring you more interesting videos from the world of military. We'll see you guys in our next video. Bye-bye.